All right, so you're in class, those who go to class, and you forgot to do the homework again. So you turn to your classmate to ask for help, and you realize you can't speak. Your face is drooping. You reach out in a panic, and you find that you can't move your arm either. So what's going on? You're having a stroke. So while you may be focused on your arm or even your face, what's really going on is in your brain. So what is a stroke exactly? A stroke is a block, often caused by a blood clot, or a hemorrhage, which is a bleed of an artery within the brain. It is currently ranked as the 5th leading cause of death and the leading cause of adult disability. About 800,000 cases occur every year in the US alone, and about 4 will occur just during my talk to you today. The major issue with stroke is that you have your initial area of damage, but this begins to grow and expand in just the couple hours following your stroke, unless treated immediately. Unfortunately, there is only one treatment for stroke, and this is called tissue plasminogen activator, or TPA, which actually dissolves the blood clot, causing the stroke. But this, unfortunately, puts you at a risk for hemorrhage, which is internal bleeding and most likely death, if used over 4.5 hours after your stroke occurs. But that sounds like plenty of time, right? Like half of a Lord of the Rings movie? Yeah, yeah? Yeah, unfortunately, it's not. So most patients don't actually come into the ER as soon as they start seeing symptoms. But for the sake of this argument, let's pretend that you do come into the ER as soon as you realize you can't speak and you can't move your arm. Now you have to be diagnosed as having a stroke with lengthy, time-consuming tests. By the time you get out of these tests, you're most likely outside of this window. And because of this, only 2 to 5% of patients are actually treated. And this should terrify you. So I actually plan to change this by looking at the blood and markers within the blood to develop a timeline for stroke. So I have analyzed 50,000 blood markers from 0 to 6 hours after stroke occurs. And so far, I have found 3 represented by BM1, 2, and 3 that show unique patterns that could ideally be developed into a rapid blood test, similar to how a pregnancy test or a urine test works. That could, you put some blood on one end of the essentially test strip, and it reads the levels of these blood markers and tells you if you're having a stroke and how long it's been since your stroke occurred. So in this case, it's been 2 hours since your stroke occurred, which is plenty of time for treatment. If this could be represented and implemented within an ER, this could dramatically increase the amount of patients who are being treated in the first place and hopefully save many lives. Because who knows, it may be someone you know. It could be you. So thank you.